I hope you're doing fantastic. Have you ever wanted to buy one of those fancy wireless meat thermometers, but maybe you just didn't have the cash? What if you could make one for yourself for a quarter of the price? Sounds too good to be true? In this video, we're going to put these two devices head-to-head and see if our homemade thermometer can handle the heat. After the demo, we'll give you a sneak peek of our first lesson in a walkthrough mini course on how to build this awesome project. Check it out. Here's the demo. Hey, so you can see this DIY meat thermometer is within 2 degrees Fahrenheit of the meter. Not too bad. The nice thing about the DIY approach is when you've made this thing yourself, you know intimately how it works. Which means you can do whatever modifications you want if you want to get more fancy. That's going to be a lot more difficult with something you get off the shelf. You want it to talk to your smart outdoor lights and turn them on and off when your steak is done so your neighbors get super jealous? Totally possible. The sky is the limit when you start to explore this world of DIY electronics. As you're going to see in this following lesson, anyone can learn how to make this device. All it takes is a little bit of patience, some creativity, and the next thing you know, you're going to be making custom projects for your friends and family in no time. Even your dog's going to be happy that you decided to start a hobby in electronics and programming. So, without further ado, here is the first lesson from our Internet of Things Meat Thermometer course. Enjoy. And so it starts. Friends, family, work, your own observations. The inspiration for a project can come from anywhere. In this series of videos, you are going to walk through the process of building a project like the one you just heard about from start to finish. Not only will you be looking over the shoulder as we develop this, but you'll be prompted to build alongside of us. Specifically, on this journey, we'll be covering a prototyping process, from drawing out the idea, putting it to words, creating specifications, and dialing in on our action steps. Selecting suitable components, deep diving into the process of reading temperatures from a thermistor, studying an equation and implementing it into code, exploring Blink, an IoT platform for developing mobile applications, writing code for communicating between your phone and an inexpensive Wi-Fi-enabled Arduino-compatible board, creating an enclosure for your project, considering future development. I would really encourage you to build this project alongside us. You can do it with us step-by-step, or if you want to watch all the course videos at once and then come back and try building it on your own from scratch and referring to the lessons, hey, that's a viable option too. Your goal for this series isn't to get through all the content and check off the boxes. I know checking off boxes, it feels good, but it's only helpful when you're actually learning the material. I highly recommend writing out the code yourself for each lesson where there's code to be written. In fact, one strategy is to try writing the code before it is demonstrated in each video, struggling a little bit to figure out a solution on your own, and then watching how it's done in the lesson. You might not always come to a solution. You might get stuck. That's okay. But the effort you spend trying is going to be worth it. I know this option would take more of your time, but it's going to be time well spent. One final note, take advantage of the video player features on the website. If the videos go too slow for you, you can speed them up with the controls. I know I'm kind of a slow talker. It's because I'm a slow thinker too. I'd rather have you spend time writing the code for each lesson than watching the video lessons over and over at normal speed. Finally, as a reminder, if you find yourself struggling with some of the concepts we discuss here, just know that that is pretty normal. Learning is like working out. If it's too easy, it's probably not doing that much. Frustration is an indicator of learning, and it should not come as a surprise. Throwing your computer out the window because of frustration, however, is kind of frowned upon. That's when it's time to sleep on the problem or ask a question. All right, I'm gonna leave you with that. I really hope you enjoy putting this project together. Have a fantastic day. Bye. If you'd like to check out this course, it's a total of 28 video lessons where we do a deep dive into the code and creating this project. Check out Programming Electronics Academy. It's at programmingelectronics.com. You can sign up for our membership. It includes this course plus many other courses that dive into Arduino programming. You'd get access to all of them. All right. Well, hey, thanks again for your time and have a great day. Bye.